Hi friends, this is Smart Exceller. In this video, I would like to share the knowledge of how to do links and hyperlinks. My previous two videos were having some annoying sounds and were giving me trouble, so I just decided to redo those videos and show you how to do links as well. So this is my database, and here I want to add a hyperlink to within each worksheet so that it is easy to access. So there are a lot of things in hyperlinks which I will be showing in future videos, but the main one related to Excel is this, that you can create sets in you can create links between workbooks, even Microsoft Word or Access or even PowerPoint also. So what you need to do is, if you want to create a link between this, so you can easily go and access these things, you can use insert, shapes, icon, models, pictures, and even word arts. So in simple way, I'll be showing you how to use in a shape. So let me draw a shape. So it's a big one, so let me make it small. And I want to make it for an international ID, so I will be typing here INT ID. So now I want to create a hyperlink. So what I'll be doing, and I'll be right clicking this, and I'll be making a link. So you can see the dialog box. It's list to exist. This is for the, it will be in this existing file. This is a screen tips. So I'll be choosing place in this document. So I want to create a link here. If it's for a new document, if you want to have a new document, you can make a link for a new document. And this is for email address. If you have an email, you can directly give a link to the email address also. However, if you have been connected and you have been mapped in Outlook. So now place this document here, and you can see that I have all my sheets are being displayed. So I'll be choosing international ID, and I'll double click it or clicking OK. So now you can see this finger has been made as a hyperlink, as you see in the websites. So when I click this, automatically it comes to the sheet over here. So now I'll be creating for the main page also. So I'll be choosing the shape, and I'll be making this so I'll be typing here as main. And now if you want to do, I will be right clicking this, and again I will go into link, and here you can see already the dialog box is here, and I'm selecting main, and I'll be clicking OK. So when I go to this, it will go to the main page, and when I go to click on this, it will go to the other page. So you can create hyperlinks, as many as hyperlinks in this. And after this, I'll be showing you how to make a links. So this report, I want to have a link. I want to have I'll be showing the same workbook. You can do this another new Excel workbook also in the same manner. So there are two ways again I'll be showing you. So one is just if you have a new sheet, keep your cursor and put an equal to sign and go to the main page. So you can see it's showing an exclamatory marks for the new tab, and you can select it and hit enter. So once you hit enter, you can pull this angry rabbit down, so you will get the things done. Now if you are good in, if you want to do this in the same way in copy and paste, you can just do this, copy this, and you can paste over here and go to paste special, and here you can see paste link. But the problem over here is the links, the cells are fixed over here. So there is no mixed reference, so it's a full absolute reference. So if I pull it down, you can see the same data is getting copied here and there. So what you have to do is, you have to just select this and hit F4 one and two times, three times, so that all the dollar signs have been gone, and hit enter. Now you can pull this down and you can fill here also. So when I pull this down, and when I pull this down also, you can see the zeros are coming there. So it doesn't look nice when you have these zeros, but it will be showing you that till where the data has been collected. But if you, the thing is, if you want to remove these zeros, you have to use this formula. You have to use this formula in the format setting. So you can select this whole area, and the easy way is right click and format. But for more convenient, I just go this way. So it will directly go to the numbers, and here if you go, it will go to the alignment, and if you go here, it will go to the font. So the easy and convenient way is over here. When you have general and all those stuff, just click on this and you can go to custom, and in custom you have to go to general, and general you have to select the whole data, and you have to type this. So it is like zero semicolon dash, it's not underscore, it's a dash or a hyphen, again a zero, again a semicolon, and at the rate of. So you can see the company name, it has been displayed. So you can see that it has been displayed over here, and you can say okay. So when you do okay, you can see that all those things have been vanished from here. But the problem is, if you have a date file, date or some specific text, then the same column you have to do manually in a short date or whatever it is, or a percentage, etc. So in next video, I'll be showing you how to make the data linking, editing the linked data. So I would like to thank for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. Please like this video. Please share this video, so many people get the benefits of using Microsoft Excel. And see you in the next video. Thank you very much.